Hello, can you see and hear me?
聞こえますか？見えますか？
大丈夫です。大鳥さん、
Excellent.
今日は、お忙しい中ありがとうございます。夏目ミクと申します。
Thank you for coming in on a busy time. My name is Miku Natsumi.
Hello, very nice meeting you.
よろしくお願いします。じゃあ、大鳥さんの、まずは、私たちの番組は朝の番組で、親と子、ご家庭でご覧になっている方が多いと思いますので、まずは教育についてお聞かせ願いたいと思います。
First of all, of course, our program is a morning news and information program, and many families, parents, and children are watching. So we'd like to ask you on questions about education.
オードリーさんは日本の漫画やアニメもたくさん読んでこられたり見てこられたりしたと伺いましたが、中でも影響を受けたものはありますか？
So we hear that you've been reading Japanese anime or comics when you were young. What kind of actual animes or comics titles that have influenced you?
I'm still watching anime and reading manga even now. Just a few weeks ago, when the Attack on Titan drew its
スーパーマ
conclusion,
ン、
I read
あ、
everything.
進撃の巨人を全部読み通しました。
But in my youth, I think Doraemon,
若い頃は、
Evangelion, and Ghost in
エ
the
ヴァンゲリ
Shell,
オン。
had the most influence
で、
on me.
攻殻機動隊が一番私に影響を与えたものです。
進撃の巨人読み終えたばかりだということですが、何か今の思考に影響したことはありますか？
So, Legend of the Giants, maybe the one you read or saw most recently, what kind of impact has it given on you?
I think the way that Attack on Titan showed that people actually shared the same
進撃の巨
concern,
人は、
but the very
の
different
中では自分
aspects of
の影響を
narrative
持っている
can
とは
give
思わない
people
と
very
答えているん
different
ですね。
interpretation on the same
少なく
historical
もなくて
event.
も、
This
同じ人
showed
の
us the
思うことで
importance of
も、何
taking
か
all the
がっ
sides
ていうも
and
のを
transculturalism.
持ってるんじゃないかと。
There's no one true narrative. It all
で、
depends
いつ
on
だけが正
which
しい答えだ
side can you
というふうに
empathize
思うっ
with.
ていうのはなくって、いろんな見方、ものに対する見方というものがあると思います。
ドラえもんについてはいかがでしょうか？
So how about ドラえもん？
In my opinion, Doraemon assists
私の思
the
想ですけれど
children to connect
も、
to each other and
子
even
供たち
connect the present
を
とthe future.
つ
But
なげ、
it's not
そして
about
兄弟
a
とも
top-down
つなげ
way
る
to decide
という、
what children must behave.
簡単にトップ
So
ダウン
Doraemon
になっていく
assists
ことじゃ
help
なく
the
て、
children. But do not rule
ドラえもん
over the
は、
children. This is where my idea about AI
子供たち
being
にはすべてを
assistive
任せられている、
intelligence
常
came
時に
from.
教えてくれるというような存在であって、上から金を押し付けるということではないことを教えてくれます。
日本ではよく子供たちの会話の中で、ドラえもんの道具の中で一つだけ使えるとしたら何を使うかっていうようなやり取りがあるんですが、オードリーさんだったら何を選びますか？
So, in conversations between children, there are many that say, what is your favorite machine or assistant device that you would like to have? What would be your favorite device?
I think it's the SEVE telephone booth where people can call into the telephone and shape the world as if a imagination become true. And it shows us not all imaginations are good. In most of Doraemon episodes, these predictions, when turned into reality, actually didn't improve the society. I think it's an excellent simulation device.
例えば、光を効率に変えるというようなものがあれば、シミュレーションできるようなものがあれば、非常に有効なものかなというふうに思います。
オードリーさんの聡明さと寛容さに日本の方もすごく影響を受けているんですが、オードリーさん、子供の頃ご両親からどんな教育を受けた、印象に残っていることはありますか？
So, we know about your intelligence. So many people are inspired by your story. So, what kind of education have your parents given to you? that has, you know, affected you?
My father adopts the Socrates method, where he does not force anything on me and just ask about my take in any situation. But when I share my thoughts, he would point out the internal inconsistency. That's to say, if I say something, assuming it's true for everyone, he would say, but it's not true for these people, right? And challenge me to think more broadly and empathize with more people.
そこでもう少し考え方を広げるといったようなことを教えてくれました。
なるほど。じゃあ解決に至るまでオードリーさんに考えさせた、大人がすぐに答えを言わないということですか？
So it means that adults or parents should not maybe just provide their answer right away, but have the chance for the children to think and come up with their own ideas and answers.
I think it's like the Pygmalion effect, meaning if the adults think their children are just babies, then the children do not have the opportunity to think for themselves. But if adults treat the children as fellow adults, like their friends, then the children are challenged to grow up and to learn more, to think about the issues with a fresh perspective. And the adults may learn something from the children too in that case.
なるほど。オードリーさんも今政治に関わる中で若い方の意見を取り入れよう、彼らに答えを出してもらうという方法を取られていますもんね。
So you're involved in politics.And you sort of, have the younger generations come up with more ideas and answers to political, issues. Is that maybe the similar approach that you take?
Yes, and I call this reverse mentorship. In some cases, the young people can also mentor the more senior people on the emerging trends and the emerging technologies. But the older people also are wise.And so they can work together as peers, not just as an adult and as a child.
さあ、ここからはですね、オードリーさん、町の方にいろいろとオードリーさんに伺いたいことを聞いてきましたので答えていただきます。
So, we have questions, from, general people, and, it'll be on a flipboard.So I won't say anything, but you please read, and then you start answering maybe in about 10, 20 seconds per question.
Simple question from junior high school student. How can I become a genius?
Enjoy the things you are doing and find a contribution to the world that affects as much people as possible. If you keep enjoying making contribution,then you will excel in your contributions. So have fun.
わかりました。では次の質問。Next, from junior high school student. Is there anything that even a genius like you find it difficult?
Whenever I think about a problem,I face the difficulty and stay with the difficulty. I don't rush to solve it. So pretty much anything I work on, I find it difficult. The trick is not to think about solving it today. Just make contributions every day. And the difficulty will live with you and share with you and teach you.
これは私からの質問なんですが、何か困難にぶち当たったときに、例えば何か気分転換のようなもの、リラックスされたりする方法ありますか？
So this is a question. Sorry. There's an internal message system going on. So.
Thank you for waiting.
No, it's fine.
So, again, so this is a question for me. Whenever you come up with an issue, you get stuck with something. What do you do to sort of refresh your mind or, you know, change your feelings?
I will look at the problem, but I would not rush to solve it. And I will sleep for 8 hours. If it's a truly difficult problem, I sleep for 9 or even 10 hours. And I wake up with some ideas.
So sleeping is very important for you.
Sleeping is when I work. Now I'm just having social interaction.
こういった形で、そう、社会的なインタラクションを取って、そういったものを楽しむ。
なるほど。続いて、from junior high school student. When you were bullied, how did you deal with it?
I read about child psychology. I tried to understand why would they bully people. And I learned to like myself and make the bullying a public issue, so I can talk about it even on newspapers and later on in books, so that in the future it will be more challenging for the bullies to do so in a way that's undiscovered.
インターネットの中で人を攻撃するということもありますが、それについてどう思われますか？また解決法というのはありますか？
Now there's more like bullying on the internet, attacking people on the internet. How do you think this issue could be solved?
In my interaction with the monitor, I don't touch the screen. I use a pencil, that's to say a stylus or keyboard, so I don't get addicted. When you're not addicted, bullying is less of a problem because you can always find a safer space to have a conversation with. Only if you're addicted do cyberbullying become a real danger to your mind.
From elementary school student, I don't like studying. How could I be better at this?
If you don't like studying, find something else you like. Practice and understand the reason how to get better. And once you do that, you will be studying that while liking it.
そうすれば自然とそれが自分の身について、それが勉強と学問、自分にとっての学問というものになると思います。
好きなものっていうのはどうやって探せばいいですか？
How can you find things that you like?
Usually for me, I sleep, I do nothing, I get bored, so I would do something that makes life more interesting. So plenty of rest and doing nothing leads to finding what you like.
本当に何もしないということが続けば、自然とそのうち何かしらやることが出てくる、逆に出てくるんじゃないかと思います。
オードリーさんからその言葉を言ってくださるとすごく励みになりますね。
So, if you, you know, tell us things like that, we feel very encouraged that you, you know, try to do nothing.
The last question from mother of a kid. Is there any word a parent should never say to a kid?
I think a parent should never say to a kid that the kid should obey. I think always qualify it with at least a reason why this rule is in place. But unconditional obeying, I think that's what the parent should never do.
So maybe in that kind of situation, what kind of words should parents provide or give to their children?
Well, for example, a parent can explain the consequence. Like if you touch the electric socket, it's very dangerous to you. You will get shocked. Very bad for your health, and so on. Always qualify the consequence before saying, never do that.
なるほど。こう、ということは選択肢、選択権は子供にあるということですね。
So the option of doing that or not doing it is up to the children.
Well, if the child is young enough, maybe you will protect the electric socket with some protective gear. I mean, that's fair. But when the child asks why, be prepared with the answer. Don't say, I told you so, that's why. That doesn't make sense.
あの、台湾ではその IQ、その知能指数の高さよりもより重んじられていることがあると伺いました。それについて聞かせてください。
So in Taiwan, we hear that there is value that is much higher, more important than just IQ. Could you tell us a little bit more about that?
Sure. Because IQ is meaningless if you have a mobile phone. With the right app, anyone can maximize the IQ test. It doesn't make much sense anymore. So sometime here, we talk about EQ, or about the emotional empathy capacity. If someone is more capable of empathizing with other people, we say they have a high EQ.
その心について、心の知能指数っていうのはどうやって高めていくものなんですか？
So how could you heighten your or a person's EQ?
Have sufficient amount of sleep. If I sleep for just 4 hours a night, my EQ drops very quickly. I could not tolerate other people as much as if I have slept for 8 hours. And other than that, practice active listening. Listen to people, don't interrupt them, and quickly, after they finish their answer, say what you have heard. Pretty much what you are doing during our interview.
で例えばこれも夏目さんが今やってる私の話を聞いていただいているというようなことになるかと思います。
なるほど、まあ、睡眠をよくとって心にゆとりを持つということなんでしょうか。
So to have enough sleep and have enough space in your heart.
That's right, exactly.
じゃ続いてですがちょっとコロナについて伺っていきたいと思います。
So next question will be about coronavirus.
台湾ではこれまでは徹底的な水際対策を取られていて感染の封じ込みに成功していましたが、今ここに来て感染急拡大起きていることをどう思われていますか？
So Taiwan has been very successful in border control and the spreading of the virus and containing the spread of the virus. But in recent days, it has spread dramatically through here in the news, also in Japan. But how are you accepting this reality?
In the past couple of weeks, our curve is pretty flat. So it seems like we narrowly avoided a lockdown. We may continue to counter the pandemic with no lockdown. And we very much thank people in Japan for sharing, for example, the AstraZeneca vaccine with us. That is very much needed now.So a sincere grateful.
本当に心から感謝したいと思っています。
いつまでに感染を、まあ、封じ込めるのか、具体的な計画っていうのはありますか？
So do you have current plans specifically in trying to contain this? Well, you said the curve is being narrowed, but really contain and control this spread of the virus.
The current no lockdown, just a telecommute as much as possible, will buy us sufficient time, hopefully, until such a day that we can vaccinate a million people every week. After that, it's just to get the percent high until we reach herd immunity.
あの日本でも、まあ、当初からそのテレワークを推奨してきたんですが、なかなかこれが思うように進まないんですが、台湾の実情はどうでしょうか。
So the government in Japan, or we in Japan, have been trying to promote, you know, remote work, work from home. But how is it in Taiwan? How can we get better at increasing the rate of work from home?
In 2016, when I joined the cabinet, my working condition is teleworking. So I'm the first openly teleworking minister. Back in 2016, just maybe 60% of public service know how to telework and is prepared about it. But fortunately, over the course of the next few years, we expanded the teleworking capabilities. So now pretty much all public servants are capable of teleworking. So we got that just in time, the broadband as human right infrastructure just in time for the pandemic.
そしてインフラも順次に整ってきた段階ですので、それがもっと広がっていければというふうに思っています。
今オードリーさんはご自身はどのくらいテレワークを実践されてるんですか。
So how, what is the percentage that you work from away from your office?
Since 2016, it's very constant. I spend 2 or 3 days a week in the cabinet office and the other part of the week away, either in the social innovation lab, touring Taiwan, or in my residence.So about 60% time I telework. It's the same now, actually. So it's good.
Yeah.
台湾で私たち今回取材をさせていただくと、とっても政府のことを市民が信頼していて、まあ、ついていこうという姿勢が見られたんですが、どうしてそんなふうになっていると思いますか。
So we feel that the people in Taiwan tend to listen to what the government says or maybe provides instructions to. How come there is that level of trust between the Taiwanese people and the government?
I think that's because our municipal and central epidemic command centers has been really transparent. Every day they answer, sometimes twice a day they answer all the journalists' questions, and anyone can call the toll-free number 1922, more than 2 million calls last year, to ask any clarifications. And sometimes their question, like the boy with the pink mask, become the national policy in just 24 hours. And that rapid response also wins trust.
何かしら電話があったときに回答して、まあ、折り返す時間も24時間以内ということに努めていますので、そういった早急な対応というのも重要なことかと思います。
はい、それで言いますと、LINE でリアルタイム24時間、いつでも市民が国に対して質問できるシステムを作られましたが、それ開発する上でポイントとなったことはどんなことでしょうか。
So you've built a LINE.A system for people to ask the government questions and then get response within 24 hours. What was the key point in developing that system?
There's many systems about using a QR code to enable contact tracing. My contribution is to take the G0V or GovZero. It's a community.Of civic technologists, people who write programs to improve the public good. So I took the best idea from them, which says a SMS is something even the very senior people who cannot scan the QR code that easily, they can still manually type the location code and send a SMS, even in place with poor telecom reception.SMS is always available. So I took the best idea from the civil society and implement that. That's my contribution. The people who actually write the code to enable it in the government is the same group of people 1 year ago that did a mask rationing system.
そういったよりこの感染を追跡しようですとか市民の不安を取り除こうというそのアイデアというのは市民の方から生まれてきていることが多いんですよね。
So we understand that those ideas, you know, contact tracing or other ideas are coming from the citizens of Taiwan, very more than, you know, from internally in the government.
That's right. And I'm very glad to see Japan also will have a digital agency with 100 people from the citizen technologists to join the central government in a very similar way as I just described. So Japan is getting there too.
そういったアイデアを政府としても取り入れていくといったような形ができてくれば嬉しいかなと思います。
なかなかのそこの部分は進んでまだ日本ではいかないんですけども、オードリーさんがその政府の中に入ったときに周囲の反発っていうのはなかったですか？
So in Japan, it's still, you know, just started and it's going very slowly actually. So there are difficulties in trying to implement such ideas. But when you joined the government, were there any, you know, oppositions or backlashes from the elderly people?
I think the reason why we didn't get such opposition is because we develop with the elderly people. My grandmother, 88 years old, advised me on how to develop such services. She also introduced her younger friend, usually 77 years old, to help testing out the mask rationing system and other systems. So because we begin by working with people in the 70s and 80s, our service are less likely to be rejected by them because they are co-designers.
あの、台湾ではご高齢の方もいろんなシステムを使えるんですか？
So in Taiwan, are the elderly people able to use such IT systems?
Yes, because we have broadband as a human right. So they all enjoy unlimited data connection. So they can try once and again, and the people in the convenience stores, in the pharmacy, are all very willing to show them how to do so. We design it so they can complete it within 5 seconds. And once they do, they can also teach other elderly people.
そしてそういったことをやっぱり慣れていってるお年寄りはやはり別のお年寄りにも教えていくといったような形ができているんだと思います。
なるほど。あのリスニングアットスケールという言葉を重要視して、まあ、今政治を進めているというふうに伺いましたが、これについてお聞かせください。
So we hear you are like emphasizing the phrase listening at scale. Could you explain to us what that means?
Certainly. In a broadcast television or radio, it's speaking at scale. So one or two people, like the two of us, can speak to millions of people watching the TV or listening to radio. But how about when we are getting the ideas from the millions of people? We have to develop something like the television and radio, but in the other direction.So like the 1922 chatbot or the 1922 toll-free number is like radio and television, but in the other direction.
あの、つまりまあ市民と一緒になって政治を変えていく。革新していくということになるんでしょうか。
So it would mean that changing politics or the government together with the citizens is important.
in a sense, voting is already like that. But the problem with voting is that we only do so every once per 4 years or 2 years. And so during the days between one voting day and the other election day, there's nothing much else in a democracy that the people can do that will hold the government to account to set the agenda. So listening as skill is making sure there's a continuous democracy between one voting day to another election day. So you can practice every day.
このコロナ禍においてはその政府に意見を上げていくという点ではやはり市民は常にその不安孤独を抱えているそれに対して政府としてはどんなふうに解消しようと思われていますか
So especially in these days of the pandemic, general citizens are feeling concerns or loneliness. How do you think the government should react to such issues?
In my personal experience, broadband as a human right is very important because if you don't have that, then the elderly people can only send text messages or pictures to one another to support each other. But because it doesn't cost anything to stream video, to do video conference, we found that the support groupOf people just video conferencing with one another every day is what's the most important to keep the families bound together even when they cannot physically visit one another. I used to visit my parents and grandparents every other week or more frequently, but I felt video conferencing is also very effective.And they're okay with video conference if they can see me very clearly and hear me very clearly.
ご両親とは今どんな会話されるんですか?
What kind of communications do you have with your parents now?
So as I mentioned, video conference, my mother makes lunchbox and send it to me every week.So sometimes I have lunch during the video conference with the bento that she made.
That's very, very, very nice.
やっぱりお母さんのお食事っていうのは特別ですか?
So is your mother's cooking very special to you?
Yeah, definitely. And that enables us to share a common topic, right? When we're having the same food together, even during the video conference, we can talk about the same thing.
そのデジタルっていうと、一見すごく冷たいもののようにも感じてしまうんですが、その中でも何か温かさ、人のつながりっていうのを感じられる方法っていうのはもういくらでもあるわけですよね。
So when you say digital, you sort of feel the word, you know, it's like sort of a cold word. But there are many ways to make that warm and have a nice and warm communication. There are so many ways to do that.
Yes, to me, digital connects people to people.
ね、私にとってはデジタルが人をつなげる。
IT connects machine to machine.
で IT は機械
と You need IT to make digital connection, but IT is not digital.
コネクションを作るために IT は必要なんですけども、デジタルは人と人のコミュニケーションをつなげるものだと思います。
なるほど。オードリーさんがデジタルでここまでいけるんじゃないかって思ってる未来はありますか
Do you have an idea of how far digital can go?In the future, what kind of a digital world do you imagine?
I think digital connecting people with different cultures, different time zones, different generations together is a way of life. Just like judo or aikido, I think digido is also a way that connects us so that we feel a co-presence. We're in the same space and time across generation and across the globe. I think this holistic feeling, this empathy, is the most important when developing the digital.
そしてコロナが収束したら、やっぱり人と人とで世界の人がもう一度顔を突き合わせて会ってみたいなと思いますね。
So when the coronavirus comes to a complete control, to a halt, we hope that, you know, people can meet face to face together again around the world.
Definitely. And I've already got one jab as of AstraZeneca. And in a month or two, I'll get another jab. And once I do so, I am prepared to visit Japan later in the year. And maybe we can meet face to face.
あの今年の終わりぐらいまでには一度日本を訪問して、でぜひあの夏目さんともお会いできればと思います。
こちらも楽しみにしてます。
We are looking forward to that.
1回目のワクチンを打って、体調の変化などはありましたか？
Did you have any effects from the first jab?
No, I just resumed work. I don't feel anything. And it probably means that my body is weak, actually. It means my immune system is not very active. But I mean, I was born with a heart issue anyway. I understand my body is weaker than others. But the antibodies, they still work.
Did sleeping solve?
Yeah, I think whatever side effect I might have, indeed sleeping for 8 hours probably solved it all. That's another good explanation.
あの台湾では、まあ、まだあのワクチンの接種、最新の情報で接種率 1.4% という状況の中で、市民の方は今打ちたいと考えている。これからどんなふうに接種のスピードを上げていこうと思われますか？
So we hear that the rate of vaccination is only up to about 1.4%. How do you plan to improve or accelerate the vaccination in Taiwan?
In mid-April, when I get vaccinated, pretty much none of my friends and families are in a rush to get vaccinated. So I had to think of a lot of ways to convince them. But now I don't have to think of anything. They're all very eager to get vaccinated. So I don't think we have a willingness problem now. Our main goal now is to work on a vaccine appointment system that will support millions of people every week.And the same team that did the QR code, that did the mask rationing, is now focusing on it.
まあ今までシステム、QR コードとか使って作ってきた人たちは予約システムに資源を集中しているという形になっています。
あの日本ではワクチンの予約、まあ高齢者の方から始まったんですけれども、まあ電話の予約だったり、なかなかインターネットの予約が難しかったりっていう中で、もう台湾ではそのシステムは構築されているので問題はなさそうですか？
So in Japan, when we started the vaccination, first with the elderly people, the web, telephones were congested, and there were many issues. But how is that in Taiwan?
When we first started mask rationing last March,We also had some congestion issue for, I think, 3 hours or so. But now that we've tested this system for a year and a half, I don't think we will face the same amount of congestion when we announce. But we will see.
まあ、ワクチンの供給次第というところはありますが、こう政府として目標とするこう すべての希望者にワクチン接種が済むというのはいつぐらいを考えていらっしゃいますか？
So I know it depends on the supply of the vaccines coming in, but、what is your, do you have any actual、specific target date or month that you would like to achieve all vaccination in Taiwan?、
I think that depends on the mixture of the vaccines available.And I will simply say that the Japanese、help in getting us there sooner than we expected, by at least a week, if not more.、I really, really appreciate the Japanese people and the government.
まああと1週間ぐらいで届くのではないかと思いますので、まあ当初予定していたものよりも早くは済ませられると思います。
あの日本では。まあ、去年、そうですね、去年の春ごろから感染が拡大して、今年に入ってからは緊急事態宣言がもうほとんどの日出ているという状況なんですが、まあ、人々はその状況に慣れてしまっているというところもあって、緊急事態宣言がなかなか効力を生まないという点もあります。これどうしたらいいと思われますか？
So first, you know, we had the first wave, last year in April.And especially since then, this year, almost you know, every day has been under the state of emergency. But the, you know, on the other side, we've gotten so used to this situation that people are not you know, listening as much as before. How do you think we should try to solve this issue?
In my opinion, what's the most important is that people understand the signs behind it. For example, the newer variants, they are more likely to transmit in a non-ventilated room. So not just mask use, but proper mask use, and also social distance, not just distancing,but making sure well-ventilated rooms are observed and so on. All these are things that people can improve in their everyday life. It's not one or two specific measure, but about getting the people understanding public health generally.
やはりそういった細かいことを本当に皆さんに理解してもらうこと、しっかりとやってもらうことといったものが大切ではないかと思います。
あの、その理解はしているんだけれども、その辛抱の時間がいつまで続くのか、まあ、経済的な疲弊もありますし、気持ちの面での人々の落ち込みもあります。そこをこうどうやって政府としてもうちょっとみんなで頑張ろうとこういう力を与えられるというか、こう一致団結させるためにはどういうことが必要でしょうか。
So there's also you know concerns or feeling you know loneliness or getting tired of this, you know, state of emergency, and how, and also there are economic issues, with you know stores not open as much, and there's also mental health issues. How do you think the government should cope with these kind of issues?
Yeah, in Taiwan's case, just today, we're working with the parliament to pass a extension to the special budget.That will enable more direct cash payments. We also made sure that for each child 12 years or younger, there's also direct cash payment, well, to their parents, not directly to them. And so I think getting the people the means to get through the time between now.And the herd immunity by vaccination is, of course, state responsibility. Having a clear timetable also helps a lot. Sure, I have maybe 5 minutes more.
あと5分ぐらいしかないそうです。
はい、大丈夫です。
Okay, sorry for the wait.
It's fine.
あの、東京オリンピックの開催、どう思われますか？
How do you feel about having the Tokyo Olympics?
I must confess, I've never watched any Olympic Games. Not anyone before it. I'm simply not a sports fan. So I don't have much opinion on this particular one either.
とても正直ですね。
You are very honest.
もし台湾でオリンピックを、まあ、例えば開催するという開催国であれば、その開催についての判断、ぜひそういうものはどういうふうにして進めていかれますか？
If Taiwan was to host the Olympics this year, what kind of a decision you think would have been made or needs to be made?
You're asking about the subject that I'm least informed, because I've never watched previous Olympics. I have no way to know what would be needed to prepare. I'm not even in the audience.
そこらはもう本当に正直わかりません。
難しい質問ですいません。
Sorry for the difficult question.
No, it's fine. I'm just saying that I think sports is of course important. It's just there's more qualified people than me to answer it.
もちろんスポーツは大事だというのは分かってるんですけども、私よりかもっと資格を持っている人が答えられる人がいる。
今コロナによって子どもたちの学びの機会が失われていることについてはどんなふうに考えていらっしゃいますか？
So the children losing the chances of education in school, how do you feel about that with the pandemic going on?
I think for once, the Taiwan people are now learning about tele-education. We've never had a forced tele-education until a few weeks ago. So this is new for everyone. It looks like broadband as a human right is holding well. We have sufficient internet bandwidth. But it does, of course, create pressure to the parents, which is why we are, giving cash to each child's household. It really increased their duties and responsibilities.So it's something new for everyone to learn, that I can say.
So
school events like sports festivals or day trips.Are being lost? The opportunities are being lost. How do you feel about those kind of social opportunities at school?
Yeah, I think of course there's creates a difference between the people graduated this year and the people who get graduated in the previous years. On the other hand, people who participate in online learning also learn some new experience.That their previous years of teachers did not have. So some experience lost, but also some new experience gained.
代わりに新たな経験といったものもできる機会もできていると思うので、まあ、失われる機会もあれば新たな機会といったものもできているかと思います。
このコロナ禍を自分の頭で考えて生き抜いた子どもたちっていうのは、また新たな経験を得て強い子どもたちになりますよね。
So the children now under the pandemic with this experience should grow to become more stronger in the future.
And more resilient. That is to say, when they face with a new situation, they can connect better with the entire world which is facing the same urgent situation. And that will empower them to work on even more urgent global problems in the future, such as addressing climate change.Achieving net zero together, and so on.
解決していく力というものはついていくんじゃないかなというふうに思っています。
最後になりますが、今この番組をご覧になっている朝ちゃんの視聴者に向けてメッセージいただけますか。
Could you give a message to our viewers?
I'll always sign off with the same message. I wish all of you live long and prosper.
いつも言ってるものですけども、長く生きて、そして、ぜひご光栄があることを願っています。
Thank you so much.
Thank you. ありがとうございました。
ありがとうございました。
And excuse me, one final request.
Okay.
If you could say in Japanese, it's a little bit long, but Asa-chan o goran no minasan おはようございます。
Asa-chan
is the program name.
Asa-chan o。
ご覧の皆さん、
ご覧を皆さん、
おはようございます。
おはようございます。
オードリーです。
オードリーです。
Okay.
In
one phrase.
Now maybe you say in one phrase and I'll just parrot you.
Okay. 朝ちゃんを
ご覧の皆さん、
おはようございます。
おはようございます。
オードリーです。
オードリーです。
Perfect.
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, thank you. ありがとうございました。
お忙しい中、時間いただきありがとうございます。
Thank you for taking your time and your
Thank you. Looking forward to meet in person someday later this year, hopefully. Bye bye.
また後ほど、はい、
見られたら嬉しいです。Thank you very much.